Okay, rolling record.
Bring up bars and tone.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5.
Ready to fade to black.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Fade to black.
10, 9, 8, 7.
Ready to fade in slate.
6, 5, 4, 3,
fade
two,
in slate.
1. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5.
Ready to fade to
4,
black.
3, 2, 1.
Fade to black.
10, 9, 8.
Ready to fade
seven,
in opening graphic
six,
and music.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Fade in graphic and music.
10, 9, 8.
Ready to fade
seven,
out music.
Six,
fade in host
five,
worries
and
over.
Your strife. 3, 2, 1.
I mean the
fade out.
Guys, it's your boy Tim, and welcome to Bear Scares. We are here with our guest, Hunter, a noted wildlife enthusiast and a bear attack survivor. Welcome to the show, Hunter.
Thank you for having me here, Tim.
Now, Hunter, how is your recovery process with your bear attack?
Well, the recovery process has been pretty good. I got to lay in bed, my roommate's out hunting for food, and I just get to listen to nature. Like, it's basically my ASMR.
Oh, ASMR, yeah. Well, I'm glad to hear you're on the road to recovery. Now, Hunter, I believe that you've been living in the forest for almost 32 years now. How's that out there?
Oh, the Wi-Fi is pretty good. Well, not exactly. Like, I have to rely on, like, hikers and other campers, like, turn on the hotspots on their phone, then I hook my iPad up to that, and I just use that to watch YouTube.
Oh, so you basically take from the hikers who go in there?
Yeah, it's not my hotspot, it's theirs. I'm just using it to my advantage.
So you're stealing?
Yes. But who's going to arrest me?
Ready, Cam 3.
Okay. Now, if you're all right with sharing, how did the bear attack happen? I got to know.
Well, so I was just going for a walk with some friends, and then I noticed a family of bears, like, down the hill, so I decided to go and take a closer look, and I recognized my friend Paul.
Ready,
Paul? The bear is named Paul?
Ready,
yeah, the bear's name is Paul. We went to high school together.
Ready, Cam 2? Cut to Cam 2?
So, you're saying a bear went to high school?
Yes, a bear went to high school, and he used to be a really chill, really cool guy, kind of popular. Like, we were pretty close friends, but I don't know what's up. But clearly he's changed because of he attacked me, and I just don't know what's up with him. Like, I meant it as a light joke. And something happened.
Well, why did he attack you?
I called his mom a salmon head.
And he knows English.
Yes, he knows English.
2 minutes to the out.
Like, this is almost like an anthropomorphic wilderness, kind of.
You're fine. Stretch
Who
it out.
Invited him? Anyway, now I heard that in the forest preserves, there's actually a gang going on made of bears. Can you please explain how that happened?
Well, apparently after the attack, Paul went to tell his bear family about how mean I was, and then the rumor just, like, spread to other bears, and it created this idea that all humans are bad towards bears, so the bears decided to, like, gang up, and now they're, like, on a mission to eliminate all the humans in the wilderness.
So you're basically saying you're the reason why there's over 30 bears running around with shiesties on.
Ready, Cam 1?
That's basically
1 minute to the studio out.
Sadly.
All right, we can wrap it up.
So that's all the time we have here today, folks. Now, remember, don't trust a bear even if you went to high school with them. Thank you for listening. I'm here with Hunter, and we're signing out. Don't forget to give yourself a big bear hug.
Forget
about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities. That's why a bear can rest at ease with just the bare necessities of life.
two,
now when you pick a pawpaw, or a prickly
nine,
pear,
eight,
and
seven,
you prick a raw paw, well next time,
four,
beware.
Three, two,
don't pick the prickly
one.
Pear by the paw. When you pick a pear, try to
We're
use
out.
The claw.
Okay.
But you don't
Studio, tell them the studio is clear, and to stop tape. Stop tape.